car vlog. We got Shredder in the back. We're going to the vet. Gotta take him to the vet. Nothing in particular. He's getting his yearly. We skipped last year's yearly, so we're trying to get them all done. I got most of the dogs done last month, but he was the last one. I think he just needs a vet check. That's all. But they're probably going to tell me he's overweight, and I don't want to hear that. But good morning, everyone. Welcome in. I didn't brush my teeth. No one look. Welcome, welcome. Whoever's watching this, welcome. If it's my main homies, I hope you had a good weekend. If it's not the main homies, I also hope you had a good weekend. I gotta get my weeds done this week. I got some spray stuff. People recommended me some sprays, and they did not work. They never do. The ones for weeds never work. Yeah, I smell good. We don't get out much, and surprisingly, he's really good with walks. I've been getting him some walks recently, and he used to pull me a lot when we walked, so I have to hire someone. But we were walking out of the door, and he wasn't pulling me, and I was like, oh my goodness. I was fully expecting him to be like, he just lunges out the door and pulls, you know, but he did really well, and yeah, it was nice. It makes me happy. Because my joints aren't so good, but if he's learning to walk better, when my joints get the littlest bit of good, I can walk him myself. The only reason why I don't is because he pulls, and I need to teach him not to. But I have nothing to do this summer but content and to decorate my home. So, ooh, these are beautiful. That's a beautiful tree. It's so large, and it had all these purple flowers. But yeah, training them is in order. All these beautiful flower trees. I would show you, but I'm too close to home, and because I have crazy exes that have restraining orders on me and still stalk me online, probably. I'd like to think they don't, but just in case they do, I have to keep things a little safe. Ugh, I do hate that this is, like, daytime. Or not daytime, morning time. Rush hour. But Shredder's enjoying it. And then afterwards, we'll get him a In-N-Out patty. Watch out, Shredder. Hold on. Hold on, buddy. I need to get a seat cover or something for him. All the dogs, they do this slippy slidey thing because it's leather seats. It's probably not so fun back there. I do want to just take those seats out, to be honest. I want to camp in this vehicle this year. Unless I get my Jeep up and running. My friend Zorby says it's probably an easy job to get it up and running. And he says it doesn't need as much work as I thought it did. So that's also cool. She's an 88 Jeep Cherokee. And I just love being able to throw my stuff in the back and put the dogs in the back and go to a campground, and that's my tent, and I just have food and clothes and stuff that I need for camping. I don't really need to bring a tent along. I have a tent, but I want to get rid of it. I have a couple tents that I want to get rid of. One's like a single person tent. Fits two people, but I prefer single person with those. Because I have doggos. But yeah, single person tent, and then I have a 6 to 8 person tent. It's a really nice tent, but I don't want it. I want a bigger tent, to be honest. If I were to have a tent, I want a bigger one. Yeah, I think this month or next month I'm gonna have a garage sale. Maybe post some of the things on Facebook Marketplace. I don't know. Anyway, I know he's going to get a checkup, and I think I'm going to ask. I don't know if they cut his nails, but I'm going to ask if they can while we're there. I know they're not a groomer. Nobody come for me, okay? But he needs his nails trimmed, and he won't let me trim them. And I can't run after him. And I prefer not to make it an awful experience for them. I know some people are like, you just gotta manhandle them. I'm not trying to frighten them with the experience. Turn this sideways now so you guys can see Shreddy boy. I don't really get Shredder on camera much. He doesn't stand out as much as the other dogs visually. Because I like a lot of black things, and he's black, so he just blends right in. Or dark things, like I have a lot of dark linens and stuff. I really like the place that I rent because it's got great lighting. just lots of windows and big windows and facing the right ways so the sun is coming in and whatnot. My apartment was like a little dungeon, it felt like, which I liked for the bit, but I yearned for the sunlight.
Good boy, shreDer.
Yeah. I've had, so story on shreDer, so you guys can, all my dogs I've bought as puppies except for shreDer. Ugh. shreDer, I got him maybe 5 years ago, maybe six. I'm not too sure.
Oh, hi. Yeah, we're talking about you. You guys stay back there, though.
I was dating this guy named Rick, who was a PEDO, so we'll talk about him one day. But I wanted a dog for Christmas, and so I asked him, like, hey, let's get a dog for Christmas. I want one for Christmas. So we went to the shelter and looked for the oldest dog, and there wasn't many old dogs. Because I'd been seeing stuff online, like, you know, old dogs passing away in the shelters, and I was like, no! No! So that's what I wanted to do, but there were no old dogs at that shelter. So then I just let Rick choose. I was like, I don't really have a preference after that, so you go ahead and choose. So he chose shreDer. And then we ended up breaking up. However, we didn't really end up breaking up. He ended up physically abusing me so bad that I called the cops and he had to move out of the house. Like, that was just legally what he had to do. And we had to stay away from each other, like the court, like, said. Which, Wisconsin, they have very different rules with DV because of all the drinking that happens. And he was drinking, so... And I don't know why Wisconsin is such a drink-heavy state, but they are. You need to get back. This is not safe. Get back. Go. Back. Get in the backseat. Go. Back. Back, shreDer, please. I worry if I had to slam on my brakes. I need to figure out a seatbelt system or some shit. I'm sure they have that by now since everything's, like, pet-friendly nowadays. Yeah, because of that, I ended up separating myself from him, which was kind of weird because, like, I wanted to be with him at the time, but he clearly didn't want to be with me. But then, like, if I tried venturing off to hang out with anyone, because he was acting single, so I'm like, okay, I guess we're single. Like, he wouldn't text me, he wouldn't anything. So I'm like, okay. And so I'm like, all right, so I'm just gonna, I guess, do my own thing. So I started getting to know people, and that meant hanging out with guys, and I wasn't, like, making out with them or fucking them or anything. He was, like, very obsessive. Like, would come over in the middle of the night. Like, I remember waking up to him, like, staring at me in the middle of the night one time. When he lived, like, 45 minutes away. Crazy. Anyway, he was being like that and eventually just stopped really talking to me in general. He had the ability to see shreDer, and he used shreDer as, like, a scapegoat, in a sense. I don't know if that's the right word. But, he pretty much, like, was trying to use shreDer as a way to stay in the house. So he told the court, he's like, yeah, that's my emotional support pet from a PTSD. La la la, I need to be able to see him. And she's like, you can pick him up and have visits, like, you can take him and stuff like that. But you're not allowed at the house. Did he ever do that? No. I had to, like, consistently tell him, hey, do you want to get shreDer or have his friend? The only time he did pick up shreDer, his friend picked shreDer up. And they went to go frisbee golfing, disc golfing or whatever. Which shreDer had a great time. But that was, like, what I imagine deadbeat fathers are like when you're trying to get child support or trying to get them to visit their kid. And I was like, this is annoying. I don't even fucking want to deal with this. So fast forward, I'm working my ass off. My grandma is on her deathbed. She's, like, one of the most important people to me. And I just decided, okay, I want to move back to Arizona. I tried to move back before she passed away, but unfortunately, timing was not right. But, yeah, took shreDer with. I actually got beef when I was down here. I don't know if I'll get more dogs. I probably will in the future, but they'll probably have different roles. They won't be so much house dogs. I really just don't want to bring dogs into my life and then potentially outlive me, you know? I don't really think I have much more than 25 years left in me. Because that would lead me to be, I'm almost 30. So that would make me 55. Wait, would it? 30 to 50. Oh, son of a bitch, what the hell is this bus doing? Trying to cause an accident, that's what. Should have let it. We could all get paid. Paid by the city. What am I doing maths for? What is this math that I'm trying to do? Now he's gonna be slow as fuck. Is this really good? I'm gonna be this asshole. God damn it. I'm sorry. Oh, are you okay, shreDer? Ah! Oh my god. This guy. Holy shit. Oh my god. That was scary. All for that? Get in front of this bus, because fuck this bus, and I don't want to be in front of this guy because he was so nice to me over. Anyway, yeah, once my dogs pass, I want to travel outside the country a little bit and then jump off a cliff. Maybe I'll find another thing to live for, but I don't really think so. So I take extra good care of my dogs. I try to. Shredder's been experiencing some discomfort lately. He's been like laying down and he'll just randomly growl. And I don't know what's going on, but that's very different. It's been like the last week that it's been happening, so. I don't know if he's constipated or what, but. His poops have been fine, I think, but they've been smaller than usual. Not that anyone cares, but. I worry, I don't want him to die. But we're to the vet. We're going to the vet. So what a good way to prevent things, right? Oh, damn, I have to go on the freeway. Ew. No. I hate the freeway so much. Especially at this time. Rush hour in Arizona? God, no. If I can avoid that, I would. And then after this, we'll go get an In-N-Out burger for the both of us. Maybe. I think I can eat a burger. I've just been eating burger and smoothie every day, essentially. Not every day, but for the most part. I just really need to make my own burgers and just get a whole bunch of In-N-Out sauce from them. Sometimes they don't grill my onions enough. First world problems. Oh no, my onions aren't grilled enough. Sorry. I won't complain. I'll just do it myself. Yeah. Anyway, I hope everyone had a good weekend. I did do a car vlog. I did like a date day, but I just didn't want to post about it. I feel like there's a lot of lurkers on my account, so I'm just trying to keep private with things right now, because people are being mean to me for literally just because of how I look. Like, I know it sounds like, I don't know what it sounds like, but I don't like being like, oh, I did nothing wrong. But literally, I'm just minding my business, and these fucking people just come and hate on my shit and be mean to me. So I just lay low, make money for a bit. But that's what I've been doing. I slept a lot this weekend. I really needed it. I don't know why I'm so fucking tired. But yeah, just a chill weekend for myself, so I hope that for other people. It's been nice. It was nice to just take the weekend off. So nice. But yeah, I went to go get my toes done. And they didn't have the nail polish I wanted, so I'll probably have to buy it. Because I don't really venture out when it comes to nail polishes, and I don't really care to get my toes done. Which I know people are probably like, well, why'd you get them done? Because I have a platform that opened up, and those kind of pictures are very costly. They cost good money. They make good money, is what I mean to say. But I'm looking at my maps, sorry. I'm not trying to seduce you. Just kidding. Yeah. So I got my toes done, and then I went to Crumble Cookie for the first time. Not that good. Really not that good. Like, if you're a sugar cookie lover, then, yeah, the flavors would be on par for you. I do not like sugar cookies. That's, like, my least favorite cookie. If I have a sugar cookie, it has to have, like, lemon in it or something. Sorry, the wind is, like, you know, how it gets. No, you gotta stay back there. You gotta stay back there. It's not your invitation to come up. He's like, oh, those windows are open. It's my sweet boy. My chat likes to call Shredder the unlocked character, and I love that. This year, I'm determined to do Halloween with them very well. I want to get into doing dog content, but there is, you know, it's difficult because I'm trying to do all these freaking platforms. There's only so much I can do, you know, as one person. If I had someone helping me with my platforms in some way, I could probably do full dog content, like just have my TikTok catering to just cute, funny dog videos, but I would have to do it on a separate page. Yeah, I hope to get that started this year, you know, because it's a good way for me to make money, but also capture memories with them, and that's the biggest thing, because I always video record them, whatever the hell you want to call it, I always record them all the time anyway, so might as well, like, if I can make money off of it, sure. You know? And I just want to do cutesy memory videos with them and, like, take them places and stuff like that. And if TikTok would pay me for that, absolutely. And now that my health is getting better, it's so nice out. It's nice and, like, overcast out. Yeah, that's something I'm gonna add this year. I've been slowly getting into it. The dogs do participate in my content a little bit more. Like, I'll do grocery hauls and I'll have Spudgy in it, or I'll do videos of them taste testing things, which I'm gonna do another one this week. It's been a bit since I've done one. I like routines. So the problem is like I have all these things, and to create a routine with it, it has to be a very precise schedule, and I haven't figured out that schedule quite yet because my joints aren't consistently like healthy. So once my health is getting better, but things are getting better. My joints are so much better this weekend, and today is starting off on a good note, so I'm really excited. I almost hope this week is going to be my last week of gimpiness. My ankles don't hurt. They get tired because I haven't been walking around a lot. They don't hurt though. My hip is the only thing that hurts and gets uncomfortable. But we're getting there. Getting there. Anywho. We're almost there. Got dog hair all over my nose. Don't mind me. Yeah, Crumble Cookie kind of sucks. I don't know how they have so many locations open. And they are so fucking sweet. Oh my god. Too sweet. Way too sweet. I can't do it. Is this person trying to race? And they're a Nissan Rogue. Yeah, it kind of would be nice to have. Okay, there, friend. The back camera for them.
The boy shreDer. So cute. He's such a good boy.
I hope it rains today. I gotta get my weeds done. I'm gonna partially do my weeds, I think, today. But what I don't understand is I paid for them to get done and they sprayed for them. Tell me why the hell they reappeared. Is that supposed to happen? Are they supposed to reappear? Stay back there, buddy. I've had them sprayed twice. At this point, why the fuck am I paying so much to have them resprayed if they just keep coming back? You know? Like, what the heck, man? shreDer, is it gonna rain today? Is it gonna rain today? Where are we going, huh? Where are we going? Stay back there. Stay back there, buddy. Thank you. Good boy. The hardest part is they want me to weigh him when we get in there. Like, they're always like, can we get him on the scale? I try to. The rest of them, they do pretty well, but shreDer, we'll see. I've been really sick the last few years, so training has not been on my mind, to be honest with you. Just trying to survive. Not die from my sickness, my illness. Getting down with that sickness. Oh, wah, ah, ah, ah. Puppy. A golf course right on the edge of the road, really? I hate those. I can't tell you how many times when I lived in Scottsdale, how many times I almost got hit with a golf ball on my motorcycle. And then the people, like, one time, the people, like, waved their arms at me, like, what the hell? Like, as if I did something. And I was like, what are you waving your arms at me for? Your ball almost hit me, bitch. What the fuck? Cyber truck! Ooh! Brother, ooh! They're so stupid looking. I don't want society to lean that direction. I don't want it to be that kind of futuristic look. I want it to be the bubbly, cute, futuristic like the Jetsons. Not dystopian dictatorship fucking Star Wars cyborg trucks. Cyber truck. No. That's not what I want. Okay, it is a little bit what I want. But no, it isn't. I don't want any industrialistic, dystopian, apocalyptic society happening. Arizona already reminds me of that because of all the dirt. All the sand everywhere. All the one color tan and then metal. It's either millennial gray or tan. What? We're almost there.
get you there here in a minute. You can take as many parties as you want.
Ugh, I love overcast. Overcast just hits so much different in the desert. It really does. I love it.
Holistic. Where are we, shreDer?
right, friends. We're here. We're here. Are you ready, buddy? Okay. We're going to go in, and I'll end up smushing this together with the on the way back and the in and out. Assuming they're open. I think they open at 10. We might be too early, so if we are, then I'll bring back in and out later for him. I think I have errands today. Anyway, I love y'all. We'll be right back. Yay! Shredder did so well. They loved him. They love him. They love all the doggos. Beef is a little dramatic. They did not have the funnest time with Beef, but he's a bit dramatic, so I'll give him that. But anyway, welcome in. Back. Welcome back. So he got a couple vaccines. He got rabies shot and distemper. And then I love the way he's splooting back there. His little foot. I'm good, Shredder. We did so good. But he's a little overweight, they said. I knew they say that. They think he has hypothyroidism, which is so cute. I did not know dogs could get that. Not cute, but, you know, it's funny that dogs could get human illnesses. I think it has to do with food, so. I think what we'll try to do,
Bitch, what the fuck?
An unprotected left? For real? I'm gonna try to amp up the walks. We're gonna get blood work done. He's gonna get a dental cleaning in July. So that'll be about $1,000, which is fine. That's kind of, you know, I put it off, their health. So I kind of expected that, like 2 to 3 years putting off their vet visits. I kind of knew. I'm happy to pay that because they're still alive. You know, I don't think just missing vet visits will kill them, but, I wasn't in the healthiest areas and stuff like that. So, yeah. Now things are getting better, finances are getting a little better, so they're my health, and then their health is like my top priority. So that's what we're doing. So July 11th, he has a dental cleaning where he'll be sedated. We'll get some blood work from him to make sure he's okay with thyroid and stuff. And during that gives me enough time to get walks going and stuff. I don't really think it's his diet. I think it's the walks. He's not very active, and it's my fault, but it's not that he doesn't like to be active. He loves it. So, but he did get a nail trimming. Yay! He got his nails trimmed. Rabies and distemper. And then the next time he goes in, he'll get blood work done, dental cleaning, and heartworm medicine. And Beef goes in next week for ear cleaning and like an ear biopsy and heartworm medicine as well. So that's about $500, so less than Shredder's, but Shredder has a dental clinic, so that's why his is so expensive. I don't generally do those every year, so this is the first dental cleaning that all the dogs have gotten, and I don't suspect I'll need to do one every year. They have pretty good teeth. I just use bones and stuff, but I want to make sure they don't get any rot in their mouth and stuff like that. I don't know if In-N-Out will be open for us to get a burger. They might be. It's probably the last thing he needs, but it's okay. He was a good boy. He did so good. And I would like a burger. And I gotta go home and sell. Because I want to pay rent tomorrow. I'm so excited to pay rent early. What? And then I gotta do my yard. Since it's overcast, I'm gonna take advantage of that and get some weeds done. I usually wouldn't do my weeds because it's too fucking hot. Too hot. My joints hurt. Like, my joints don't hurt as bad, but with both of those combined, I do not want to do that, you know? Oh, dude, why are you all the way on the left? This is not a two-laner.
Turn left onto South 48th Street.
But since it's kind of rather decent out, I'm going to do that. Maybe open up the pool for the dogs. A spot with a pool for the dogs. I use Sniff Spot, which is you can rent people's backyards And some people have pools. That's what I plan on doing at the end for my birthday. Not for my birthday, but like somewhat part of my birthday celebrations will be including the dogs. Oh, those guys. For my birthday, I want to. I know there's a dress that I want to get that I've always wanted, and some necklaces that I've always wanted. But yeah, this year I just really want my health back. I want to go to the art museum, I want to go to the botanical garden, and be able to do those things that I haven't been able to do for years. So I don't really see my birthday being like an expensive year this year. I might rent an Airbnb up in Sedona for a little bit and invite my friend Sierra. But other than that, usually I go all out for my birthdays. I think I talked about this before. Like, I will celebrate the whole month, and I still probably will. Like, I'll celebrate by going out to eat at different places and stuff, because hopefully by then my joints are well. This year, there's not much going on. I've spent all the years getting everything I ever wanted, and I don't really have anything that I want anymore. Like, I have bigger items like my restaurant and stuff, but those take my personal work, you know? All of these take my work, but nonetheless, it's a different goal. But maybe this year, I just think I'm going to just take it easy and just look cute, go out to places to eat, make sure my dogs are happy, have a good celebration, because Spudgy's birthday is in July, too. So, and I missed Beef's birthday because I was struggling a bit with finances then. So we're going to combine them all in July and do a birthday party for them. I always celebrate their birthday individually, like by giving them a bone and celebrating happy birthday to you. But like, it's their special day. Oh, there's a puppy in this car too. But, oh, you sleepy shredder. They said he'd be sleepy after these vaccines. But, yeah. We'll have a good little party for all four dogs. We're celebrating Spudgy's birthday, but also celebrating Beef's, Odin's, and Shredder's at the same time, because why not? Because the pool is for the big dogs. The little dogs don't care so much to be in a bigger, different yard. They like to smell different things, but other than that, they don't care too much. Hi, puppy. Hello. So cute. I love it. Oh, shit. Distracted by the dogs. I love him. He's so cute. Boba day. You know, I used to love Boba, and now it's like right back to where it was. Like, meh. I went through a phase of it. I probably would again, but it's just so much sugar. It's, like, not worth it for my body. Yay, I'm glad that's taken care of, and Beef is next week. I'm so excited. I know bills are, like, strenuous to people, but I've always worked sales. Not always, like, I worked sales. That was, like, one of my favorite things to work when I was working for, like, corporate people and stuff. And I kind of view what I do now as a form of sales. It is, you know. But nonetheless, all these puppies are out. I love it. Hold on, Shredder. Andy's frozen custard. I want to join. Not join. I want to try that. Their sign said join the team. I was reading that. Macayos. I love Macayos. One of my favorite Mexican food chains here. A lot of Mexican food chains can whitewash it, but they do pretty close to authentic without missing out on the quality and stuff. They're not all the way authentic, so sometimes I don't like their rice. I'm very picky about rice. If it's not authentic rice, then I'm really picky about it. So Macayos isn't authentic rice, but they're pretty good. A lot of people who don't do authentic rice, they end up ruining the quality of it. It's like soggy, and it's like sticky rice. And if you've ever known, like, Asian rice compared to, like, Mexican style rice, Mexican style rice is more loose. Like, it doesn't stick together quite like Asian sticky rice does. Both delicious equally. I fucking love rice. But people here they don't do the steps right, and it, when you combine that with Mexican rice, it just doesn't hit the same. But Macayo's does really good Mexican rice. They do. Not as authentic, like I said. It's still, it could use a little more flavor. But yeah. Love this song. I saw a century plant. It was in bloom. I love that. Magical. Make sure you guys have. There's just a lot of flowers and a lot of, I don't know, trees. Where I lived in Arizona before, it wasn't this much greenery and stuff, and I like it. I like it a lot. There's a lot of oleander bushes, and I don't know if they're in trees, but they look like trees. They're nice. They're beautiful.
Continue straight onto South Point Parkway East. Continue straight onto South Point Parkway East.
Look at this pretty golf course over here. It's just so nice.
For half a mile.
Oh yeah, I was saying with bills. Honestly, like, I've never hated paying bills. I know some people hate paying bills, but I love them. I grew up in such an abusive home when I was younger that I literally just wanted nothing more but to be on my own. To get out of that house to, you know. Oh, that's lovely. There's a whole bunch of garbage in the middle of the street. Who did that? And now that I am, I know a lot of people are like, I wanted to grow up so bad as a kid and now look at us. Like, you know, I love it though. I love it. There are challenges, but I think everyone can be successful. We're all handed terrible hands, a lot of us, you know, but that doesn't mean you can't be successful. And I've never had this idea in my mind that I wouldn't be successful. I always thought I would be. As a matter of fact, when I was a kid, I always thought I would be a millionaire, and I just carry that idea with me throughout life and just hope I'll make it there. But, you know, I love paying bills. I know it sounds crazy, but the bills that I pay, it's just a reflection of what I have. You know what I mean? I'm paying my car bill. That means I have a car. I get to pay gas. That means I have a fucking car to put gas in. You know, same with my house. And the fact that I get to rent a house alone, that's a huge blessing. But on top of it, be able to pay for it alone, even bigger blessing. And I'm grateful every time I pay my rent, and it's like, wow, I made it another month. And my bills, they've increased a little bit since I've moved here, which is fine. I assumed they would. But my quality of life has gotten so much better, and the bills are so much worth it. Before, like, I was living in this nasty-ass little rinky-dink apartment, and it just wasn't worth it to me to pay so much rent, you know? But when you really follow through with what you feel like you deserve and live through that, then you'll eventually be in a place where you feel like you deserve it, and you're happy to pay rent because you feel like this is the place I deserve to be at, you know? And then going about making that rent is a lot different. You know, I've always made rent, but I knew it required me to put my head down a bit more and do a little bit differently how I was before and more intentional and stuff. And now I am, and it's paying off slowly but surely. My goal this year is to reach 3 million on my platforms. And then on top of it, I want to be making 7 figures. I would love that. Wouldn't everyone, though, right? But I'm willing to put in the work. I've been putting in the work. I've been putting in crazy amounts of work. So, I've got a little over 7 months left, and I'm just going to grind hard. Although, I don't believe, you know, for me, my philosophy stands in a fine line of not overworking yourself and valuing yourself and trusting that the universe will bring you the opportunities that you seek because you deserve them. And did I go the wrong way? Oh, I think I did. Yeah, I did. And if you live authentically and like through happiness and things like that, like I really do think the universe will bring those opportunities to you. And, you know, it doesn't require overworking yourself at all. It requires putting in a lot of work, but overworking yourself and running yourself into the ground and shit, nah. I don't believe in that. I used to, but I don't believe in that anymore. It's not to say that you can't get a lot of money and wealth by doing that, absolutely. But does it always pay off? No. For people who are chronically ill and physically can't do that, it's not an option. So to me, I always wanted to work smarter, not harder. And make my money work for me. I don't want to work for my money. I want my money always flowing in when I'm sleeping and everything. And so far, like, I'm not a millionaire, but my life is set up that way. Like, I've intentionally made decisions so that my life could be that way. And people are always like, oh, that would be nice to make money while you sleep. But yeah, it is. It is very nice because I intentionally set it up to do so. Anyone can do that. Stocks, subscription services, set up your own subscription online. The online world to make money is incredible. Get into it. Get into it, y'all. You don't have to do what I do. You don't have to do photo shoots. Shut up, lady. I'm going to In-N-Out. You don't have to do what I do or anything. But, yeah, there's tons of money in the internet world. Does it hurt to explore it a little bit? Shut the hell up, lady. I'm getting a damn burger. This blue car is here again. They must work at Starbucks. Every time I come here, this pretty blue Honda. What is it? Honda? No. What is this? Is it an Acura? Oh, it's a Hyundai. It's so pretty. It's a light blue one. It's like a little hatchback. Yay, they're open. Well, Mr. Shredder, today was a fancy day for you. You got a pedicure? I got a pedicure this weekend too, so we're twins. They trimmed his nails. Yay! They're getting pretty long, and he doesn't let me trim them. And now we're gonna get you a burger. We prepaid for your dental surgery in a couple months. Who is that girl? So responsible. I'm really trying. I wanted life to be better for me and my dog, so I really, like I said, did this intentionally. Good morning, how are you? Can I get the double protein style? Okay. And can you do double whole grilled onion on that? And then a puppy patty. And that'll be it. Yep. No. To go, please. Thank you.
Okay, here's a good boy.
Oh, there's a fly in here, of course. Of course. Can I get a picture of us?
Jeez.
Hello, good, how are you? Yep. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it. You too.
It smells so good. Oh, are you drooling?
Are you drooling?
So cute.
Sounds like my camera thing might be coming off soon.
Such a good boy.
I'm like so stoked to pay rent early. I've never done that. I'm just excited. Because then I can focus on... No, you gotta stay back there, honey. Focus on paying my grandpa back. That's been so on my mind. I'm gonna give him his patty so you guys can see, but I'm gonna eat mine at home. Maybe I should eat mine in the car. Maybe? Nah. I kinda want to, but I just don't wanna ruin my lipstick. Stuff. I think this week I'm working on rent, but I want to get the dogs a walk too. I'm going to have to schedule shredder something. I'm going to have to figure out something. At least until my joints are better, and then I'll walk him. I kind of would like to get a quad or something. So that way when I can't walk, I can just go on the quad and take him. I mean, I probably don't need a crazy large quad, you know, I'm small. I'm only going to take him for walks. Probably only need like a 125cc. Those are kind of small though. That's the problem, I don't want him to be able to pull the whole thing, you know. So maybe a 250 would work. Like, he's pretty strong, but at least on a 250, I don't think he'd like drag the whole thing with. I think he would on a 125 I don't know if they make a 150, but if they do, then it's still too small. Maybe I will eat in the car. I don't want to get another patty for the dogs.
I cannot take this anymore.
Today's going to be a real good day. I don't know why, but I just feel it. It's already been a good day. And I get to pay rent tomorrow. Yay! I'm going to do my weeds. And there's not many weeds. My neighbor thankfully took care of their weeds, so the amount of weeds I have to do is way less. Because our houses are like right next to each other. So I never know really where the line lays, and when they get their weeds done before me, they clean up a little extra into my area, so I get to clean up less. So I want to take care of that before it spreads into their area. There's really not that many weeds, thank God. But before the rains come, I want to take care of it. Rain down in Africa. And I even got like de-weeder things, and it doesn't work. No matter what de-weed shit I get, it never works. I sprayed the yard, they're still there today. It said 3 hours. In 3 hours, you would kill these weeds. Did they? No. It did not. I need to wash my hair. You can't tell, but it's kind of dingy. It's not as white. It's okay. I'm gonna go silver white today. Back and they take him to the back to like weigh them and like do all the whatever. They're like, he's like a sausage bear. I'm like, that's so cute. Never heard someone call him that, but I will call him it now. But hopefully he's healthy. Things are fine. I can't imagine. I really don't think he has thyroidism, and truthfully, I really do believe in holistic a lot. I think if he does have thyroidism, then we just look at his diet and his exercise. And the vet said that doesn't really work much, but people stick to dog food, that's why. In my opinion, I'm willing to go and I make my dog's meals. Like, I'm willing, if he needs it, like, I'm willing to make all of them. But everybody on TikTok's like, he's so fat. No, leave him alone. He's chunky, okay, I know. But he's gonna be better this year. We all are. It's gonna be the best year for all of us. The best to the rest of the best years. The start to the best. What am I saying? You know what I'm saying. I see the same dudes here every time. I guess they just come into work every day. I always see this as like a high school job, but I guess with the wages they pay, it probably isn't, huh? Shit, if I was working in the real world, I'd probably work here too. A new classic, In-N-Out.
Maybe your burger patty's better.
My joints have been feeling good lately. I've been going extra hard on my holistic shit. I gotta make more medicine today, speaking of. Lots of garlic. stock my fridge up so I only have to shop in like 2 weeks. That's my goal. The end of the month, I want to be able to be doing that. I'm almost there. I gotta get some more strawberries and blueberries. There's a whole bunch in the freezer still. But I went shopping last week. So hope I can stock up enough this week to where I don't have to stock up for another 2 weeks. And because I can pick things up and go in store. Thank you. You too.
Maybe I'll be able to get everything finally.
I'm just gonna let you go ahead. Okay, go ahead. Come on, go ahead. Poor people. This is like a crazy little area. Thank you. What is this car? It's nice. An Audi. Ooh, I like it. I don't enjoy shopping too much, to be honest. If I could go inside, I would. I just don't like getting all these things from all these places, so I have to get delivery.
Ingredients.
sure there's no one around while I say that. The window's open. But yeah, if you're seeing this, if you made my burger and you're watching this, give me that ass more. Or girl, I guess. We're doing it. I don't swing that way, but hey, the people will love it. Also, I've never eaten ass. I don't know how to do it. I'm also autistic, so I'm a little scared to attempt because I might take the eating a little too literal because I really don't know what I'm doing. Are people like on people's asses? Or is it like when a dude goes down on me, but like on their ass? Is it like that? That makes sense, but wouldn't that be a rim job? Or is a rim job just you licking their butthole rim? I grew up Mormon, okay, I'm sorry. I'm too scared to Google this. Funny enough, I make corn, but I do not watch it. Back and stream, do my weeds, my garbage. sell some more.
What?
That's what my life looks like. Like I said, this is a good way for me to mentally kind of figure shit out. That's why I like these car vlogs, because I really drive just to sort out my mind. And if I have a camera, I don't mind people giving input on my life, because usually I'm usually looking for input, to be honest. Like, if someone gave their opinion on shit that I was talking about, wouldn't care. Usually I care about unsolicited opinions or I didn't ask kind of thing, you know? But when you put your life like this on, you kind of got to expect it. But also, a lot of times when I'm brainstorming, like, I don't have a set view in place. So if someone came in and was like, hey, you're brainstorming about X, X, and X, like, what if you did this, this, and this? And I'm like, ooh, okay. You know, what is this? Oh. Lettuce. Oh, I can't wait till I'm off these meds. I usually don't have, like, a little chin right here. But it's okay. It's temporary. It's temporary. Home we go. It's always funny seeing these big-ass lifted trucks in the Starbucks drive-thru. Hold on, I gotta get these instructions off. Okay, now we're good. Ooh-wee. I'm full. I could use a coffee. I haven't had coffee in forever. Should I? It's like, I would go to Dunkin'. I don't really ever know, but it always makes me shaky. But I did just eat. Yeah, I will treat myself to a coffee. Is that delivered? This week is going to be a good week. Just looking forward to getting my rent paid. Weed's done. Dog walked. You know how it be. me that, like, all I needed was just your support. That's all I needed. And some people go over and beyond and they support with financials or they send gifts on Amazon and stuff. But in general, just people being there for me and not being negative and being positive and being like, yeah, you can do it, blah, blah, you know, that's the kind of support that I wanted. And I always knew I could do it. So it never really was like, oh, I only think I can do it if I had the support. But it was more like, okay, I know I can do it, but I know this would come out so much better if I had the support that I wanted, right? And it built my community, and I was kind of thrown into doing that. I didn't really want to. My OF got shut down, and I just had to turn to my community. And I wanted to do that originally, but I was too nervous to. Because I just got a lot of hate online, and I just kind of dealt with the trolls. I got my way through it, and now we're on the way to the road that I've been wanting to go on, and I'm so excited for it. And it's all fucking thanks to y'all. Don't know what I'm looking at, actually.
Okay. Hello, welcome to Nothing Going On from my house.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm doing good, and you? What kind of better for you today?
Can I get a medium iced coffee?
Medium iced coffee?
Yeah, can you add toasted almond and hazelnut into that? And extra cream.
Anything else?
And then like 5 packets of stevia on the side if you don't mind. And that'll be it. Thank you. I always wish these people could get tips. I know if you try to give them a tip, they won't accept it. Even though I don't believe in compensating for, you know, employers' lack of paying their employees. But I just feel like a tip would make some of these people's day much better. That lady sounds like she's going through it. Grab this water. Do they have a garbage? Probably not. Anyway, I'm beyond grateful for y'all. Thank you so much, and just for watching my videos. Soon I'll be monetizing on YouTube, but I just wanted to, you know, build my community more, try to help as many people as I can before I die. And really my philosophy with that is, like, if I could just help as many people as I can, I feel like the universe will just take care of me. If I need help with my dogs, if I need help with my home, whatever. I'm not a very materialistic person. I like things. I like material. I like cars. I live in a nice house. I love shoes. I love hats, you know, but nothing crazy expensive. I don't know if I'll ever spend 10 grand on a purse, maybe one day, but I just don't find the need for it. And I think that money could go to helping people more. That's more worth it to me than a purse, you know? Especially because I struggle with finding purses that I like. I like this one. It's a little crossover body bag thing, but other than that, I don't know how to wear purses. No one taught me. And I don't know if my grandma, she carried purses. I don't remember how she carried them though. In your head, yeah. Yeah, so far just trusting in the universe, God, whatever you want to call it, has really provided a lot for me. And I think that's what they mean by turning to God. It doesn't have to be like God in the Bible and stuff, although the Bible has so many. So. Okay. So many symbolic parables, you know. Very useful to correlating to life and things, but in general, you don't have to believe in God for the blessings and miracles of God to apply to you. And I think that's what, you know, Christians are trying to do. They want you to get the benefits of God and believing in God and stuff like that. They kind of tend to go about it the wrong way. You don't have to believe in God like that, you know. Hello.
Did you want the stevia?
Yeah. Thank you.
Is that like tattooed eyeliner?
Here?
Yeah.
No, it's a tattoo, but I put eyeliner over it because it's like kind of, you know, faded a little bit.
I like it.
Thank you. I love your look too. I looked at you, I was like, oh my God, it's a fairy working at Dunkin'. Thank you so much. Have a good one. That just looks like a little fairy. I hope people take that as a good thing. I personally think it's a good thing to look like a fairy. I don't know what other people think, though. Last time I got a large, it was so disgusting. With, like, 70 million stevia still. So hopefully this medium does a trick. It doesn't jack me up too much. I remember meeting my mom for the first time when I was 18. I've met her, like, when I was, like, 6, 7 was, like, the last time I remember her. I don't have good memories of her. She's an awful person. You know, usually I don't always side with the men when it comes to marriage and divorces and stuff. But that one, I thank my dad for getting out of that shit as soon as he could. Because although my life sucked, it would have been way worse if she were involved in my life. So, is what it is. But he did the best he could. But yeah. I remember when I first met her. Ooh, yummy. I remember when I first met her, she was ordering coffee like crazy. Like, she ordered like 7 coffees while we were at dinner with my ex. And, the look he gave me, he kept looking at me like, is she really ordering another coffee? But I understood it at the time because, like, oh shit, I could just go left. There's not a lot of cars. I'm gonna go left. Ugh! But, yeah, my ex looked at me like, is she really drinking that much coffee? But I can relate, because as an ADHD person, I used to just drink coffee like water. Like, it was nothing. That's actually why my teeth are so white lately. It's because, well, they're not, I haven't brushed them, don't look at that. Ignore that. I'm like, that's why they're so white lately. Yellow. I haven't brushed them in a bit, though. I'll be honest. Sometimes I brush my teeth probably once a day when I'm good. But, like, every other day is kind of my norm, which I'm fine with. I don't have cavities or anything, so I don't really care. And I don't consume sugar, so that kind of helps. Helps a lot, actually. But, yeah. That lady's crazy. My mom. Like, I thought I had bad ADHD. She's got worse. Way worse. I think that's where I actually get the ADHD from. I think the autism is from my dad. My brother is autistic. But they used to call back in the day. I don't know if they call it now Asperger's or whatever. That's kind of where he falls in the line. But yeah. Thank you for this coffee, y'all. Thank you for my lunch, breakfast. Usually when I'm by myself, I thank the universe for this, but thanks. Since you guys are here, in a sense, you will be when I post this video. I want to thank you all while I'm at it. I'm always just very grateful, even, like, the smallest things. I am so adamant about people practicing gratitude, and people think it's just about saying you're thankful for things, and it's actually being grateful. Like, you actually have to feel it in your heart, like, feel grateful. You know, I get flustered really easy, so I am really grateful for, like, good traffic, or, like, if I have to park somewhere, and there's no parking spots by the place, like, I'll get flustered because I can't walk very well still. So it needs to be, like, real close. And usually, whenever I go out, there happens to be a parking spot, like, real close. And I'm like, thank you, universe. Thank you so much. Like, yay. And it's just about getting excited and grateful about those small things. Like, I'm just grateful. Every time I come out into my car, I'm grateful. I'm still shocked that I have a fucking car. And when I got this car, I was nervous because I didn't think I'd be able to keep up with the monthly payments. But I was like, you know what? Having a car is going to give me more content, and it's going to give me better opportunities to do other content because I couldn't go anywhere on my bike or anything. So I was just stuck to the house. So I was like, this is worth it. The $400 a month, I can make that extra amount and the gas and stuff. And, you know, it's probably about $500 extra a month with insurance, gas, and everything. My insurance isn't crazy. It fluctuates month to month depending on how much I drive because it's per mile. But it's about $60 to $90 a month. Still not bad than what I was quoted. Because, you know, being a first-time driver with insurance and stuff like that, I wasn't insured when I had vehicles, like my Jeep and stuff. But, and I didn't have a license. So I just recently got my license thanks to my friend Sierra. She's fucking wonderful. Shout out to Sierra if you're watching this. You're wonderful. But she knows it. But I can't wait for her birthday. She and I share a birthday month. Actually, but all my best friends have always shared the birthday month somehow. We always share the same month. But my best friend Summer shares a birthday month with me. And then my best friend Sierra. I want to make Sierra a cake. She wanted that cake that says, you know, it's funnier than 24 or 25 from SpongeBob. Because we're big SpongeBob fans. I didn't make it for her last year. I wanted to. I think it was the year before, actually, I was supposed to make it for her. And I think she's turning 27 this year. It's been such a beautiful honor to watch her grow. But for real, I grew up with her in the group home for a bit, and it's just, when people talk about lifelong friends, I think of Sierra. I really do. She's not too insertive in my life. A lot of my friends try to do that. They're just too much into my life. Like, and I've got bad ADHD. Like, I will disappear for 3 months, but it felt like I disappeared for a month. Like, not even that long. Next thing I know, it's been 3 months, and I'm like, oh, fuck. You know? Same thing with the weeks. Like, 3 weeks feels like 1 week to me. 3 days feels like 1 day to me. I don't know why, but I get lost in, like, a time loop in my home. Because I don't leave very much. I just focus on content, making money, and my health. And with my joints not being amazing, I don't really want to go to all these places, you know? If I have to walk, I don't want to go. But I don't really go many places, and that also that helps with insurance and gas. So it's a nice car. But in general, because I don't go a lot of places, that also helps propel my gratitude. Because when I go out, it's like, oh my god, you know that dude? Oh my god, that's how I feel every time I go out. Because it's like, what? Trees. Oh, I just spit everywhere, but whatever. Anyway, yeah, I love it. So it keeps that gratitude up, and that kind of helps my manifesting, and yeah, so that helps me get what I want, because I believe I deserve what I want, and that's how manifesting works. You gotta really believe you deserve it, and you get it. So if you don't believe you deserve it, you won't go after it, and you won't initiate that energy. And a lot of people think that they can manifest and just sit there, but you gotta initiate that energy. You know how Newton's law is, like, once there's that direction, it'll keep going unless something stops it or whatever. The laws of motion or whatever the fuck. I'm not a scientist. Dude, it's a red fucking light. Look at this guy. He's, like, past the line, and he's just in such a hurry. That's Arizona. That's literally Arizona. Nobody gets a shit here, and I hate it. That's okay. I guess I chose to live here, so whatever. Birdie, get out of the road! Oh my god, you're gonna get hit! Get out of the road! Get out of the road! Stop eating! Get out of the road! Oh my god! Why'd you run across the street? He didn't even fly across the street. He just ran across the street. He made it, but still. He must not give a shit about life. Damn, that poor bird. How you doing, shreDer? Yeah, they said he'd be sleepy after the shots. He's pretty sleepy. He got a burger. He got lots of sniffing in. Maybe tomorrow, Wednesday, we'll get a walk for him. But if you want to donate, a lot of people. but that's how I get the walks done. Is someone always ends up donating like $25 and then I just get a walk done for him. So if you want to donate $5 towards his walk, $1 towards his walk, there's a link in my bio. There's Cash App and all that good stuff. I'm always open for donations. A portion of what I receive in the month, donation and subwise, goes towards my community right back to it. So I'd like to think it's worth it in the end for anyone who donates. What happened here? An accident? Ooh, God, a big one. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I hope that person, the whole front half of that fucking van is gone. It is gone. Someone must have been turning out that fucking... One car is flung all the way across on this left side. That front half of that van is gone. They must have been pulling out of that. There's a gas station. Must have been pulling out of there and collided. My goal in life is to never get in a car accident. I do not want that to ever happen. My grandma never got in a car accident. She got in a little fender bender. A little old person rear-ended her. But she never got in a car accident. I have gotten in a bike accident a couple times. My first one was a hit and run. Some lady hit me. It was not my fault. And then the next one that I remember, I think I got in another little... I don't think so, actually. I think I only got in two, then. I've laid my bike down a lot more than two times, but the second time that I got in a wreck, I was trying to do a wheelie. I was really upset, and I tried to do a wheelie, like, just to get some energy out, and it was raining. I don't know why I did this, okay? But, yeah. And then it slipped out from underneath me. And then I ran back to the car behind me who had stopped, and I was like, do you mind driving me up to my bike over there? And she's like, yeah. And she's like, are you okay? I was like, yeah. A little skirt up, but I used to get my bike. And then by the time I got up there, there was a couple gentlemen who had saw the accident happen, and they rushed across the street, and they were already picking up my bike before I even had time to get there. I was so grateful for them. They were so nice. Every time I've laid my bike down and stuff, there's always been some guardian angel there to protect me, in a sense, but they've always, if I, you know, laid it down like that, they were there. And even in general, if it was, like, a nice way that I laid it down. Like, one time, I was at a light, and I laid it down. Because I was in the middle of a turn, and the person had, like, stopped or something. So, in the middle of a turn, I, like, stopped, and then, like, whoop, bike laid down. I'm not strong enough to pick it up. But luckily... By the time I got up, there was two dudes there. Like, one dude was running up to me, and I still remember being on the ground as he was running up. And I got up, and then another guy came out of his truck that was behind me. It was a big-ass semi-truck behind me. And the driver came out, and they're like, are you okay? I'm like, yeah. And then they're like, do you need help? I was like, yeah, if you guys could help me pick up my bike, that'd be great. So they helped me pick up my bike. Bada bing, bada boom. Anyway, I'm home, y'all. So, thanks for hanging out with me. I love you guys. Take care of yourself, okay? Eat and hydrate. Maybe get yourself a little treat. Oh, God, the neighbor's parked so close to me, it's almost hard to get in. Anyway, thanks for joining me. Take care of yourselves. Like, subscribe, share, whatever the hell you want to do. I don't care what you do. I just appreciate you watching. But stay amazing. That's what I care you do. And I care that you eat and hydrate, okay? Anyway, toodaloo, y'all. You'll see this up today, hopefully. But thanks again. You're wonderful. Much love. Bye-bye.